Kia ora, ladies and gentlemen, please be upstanding for our opening karakia. We kindly ask that devices are switched off or on silent. Tūtau mai runga, tūtau mai raro, tūtau mai roto, tūtau mai waho. Kia tau ai te mauri tū, te mauri ora. Ki te katoa, haumie, huie, tai, kie. Okay. Please be seated. Tālofa lava, ilo wawa, ma lo wha aloa lava. O te wha tālofa atu, ma o wha apea atu, tālofa, tālofa, tālofa lava. O lo ingoa o tūsinga sina o ne se mo wha tālofa toa. A whio mai, ma leo mai. Se iyo tato moli mawina le nei afi afi taua, mo ima tole whanau. A very warm welcome to this evening's special event. My name is Sina Onesimo Toa, and I've had the honour and blessing of serving as the Deputy Head Girl for 2024. It is my privilege to welcome our Board of Trustees Chairperson and Board of Trustees members in attendance, our Principal Ms. Gordon, invited special guests, our staff, and our wonderful senior students and whānau to the Hamilton Girls High School Senior Academic Prizegiving for 2024. Today, we celebrate academic excellence and student leadership in our school, and it is my privilege to commence our celebrations. Throughout tonight's program, student leaders and select staff will be announcing the recipients for a variety of awards, and we'll also take in talented performances from our school's musicians and cultural groups. I look forward to a fantastic celebration. Could you please be upstanding for the national anthem? Please be seated. I would now like to invite our board chairperson, Carissa McKay, to speak, followed by our principal, Ms. Gordon.
Monu! Monu! Monu, tangaloa. Ke hake ke pū I lunga he langi ke hifo ke pū he lalo whonua. Mō nū, mō nū, mō nū tangaloa. Tēnā koutou katoa. Ko te moana nui e kiwa, te moana. Nō niwe aho. Kei kirikiri roa tōku kāinga, ko Carissa tōku ingoa. Nō reira, tēnā koutou. Tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā tātou katoa. I would like to first acknowledge the traditional owners of this land. We pay our respects for their elders past and present, and recognising Māori as tangata whenua, and embracing te tiriti o Waitangi and Māori as tino rangatiratanga of Aotearoa. Tēnā koutou. Tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou katoa. It has been an honour again to represent Hamilton Girls High School as the Board of Trustees presiding member. That's chairperson in old language. Thank you for the opportunity to deliver the opening speech. On behalf of my colleagues, Dr. Shane Edwards, Sarah King, Jess Horner, Josephine Satini, Kristen Cato, the staff rep, and student rep, Alice McCartney, we welcome you all to celebrate the outstanding achievements of all of our students. This is a special occasion where we come together to recognise the hard work, the dedication and talent that have been showcased throughout the year. Tonight we celebrate the achievements of our students, but also our staff. Our students have demonstrated exceptional academic achievements, participated in a wide range of extracurricular activities, and made significant contributions to our school community. As I reflect on the past 12 months, I am mostly filled with a sense of pride and accomplishment. We have welcomed exceptional new staff to our team and sadly farewelled some. Sadly, we have mourned the loss of our school kaumātua, Mātua Takitūna, and Kingi Tuheitia. This was and remains a significant loss to our kura and our community. Despite the sadness, we have also celebrated great achievements from our current and former students in all areas of school life. And if you've just watched The Voice Australia in the last few days, you will see some of our former students there. As a board, we have seen so much growth and development. Our work is not just about the ongoing cyclic maintenance of school buildings, a bit boring, classroom fittings and furniture, or resourcing to support learning. We try to stretch our dollar as best we can, and we continue to work towards future-proofing by ensuring our buildings are safe, they are aesthetically pleasing and fit for purpose. This year, the Educational Review Office, ERO, returned after 4 years hiatus to review our school, and we are greatly encouraged by the results of this review as we strive towards excellence for our learners and our kura as a whole. We have done much needed asphalt repairs. You've seen the potholes everywhere. Approved the purchase of a new school van, acquired new rugby posts, a new electronic board, invested in exploring options for improvements to our field to ensure the field is properly utilised, but also allowing flexible use of that space. We have invested in refurbishments to much needed spaces like the hostel and the classrooms. We have just signed off on a roofing contract to ensure proper maintenance and to avoid costly repairs should anything happen suddenly. And lastly, I'm very pleased to announce that our capital works, the performance, health and wellbeing project is now back on track and looking forward to a projected start midterm next year, mid-year. We are excited about the potential of our school community and the bright prospects ahead. Together, we will continue to strive for excellence, foster a culture of learning and innovation, and create a supportive environment where all students can thrive. I would like to acknowledge the outstanding work of our teachers, our learning support staff, and all staff. Led by our principal, Mari Gordon, and Craig Scrimger, along with the amazingly talented and supportive senior leadership team, and all of our staff, teaching and non-teaching, your commitment to providing high-quality education is evident in the successes of our students. You go above and beyond to support and inspire our young people. Your dedication is truly commendable. The support does not end in the classrooms, as evidenced from when you walk through the front gates to the admin block and other areas of our school. Without you, our school will not look as good as it does, nor run as well as it does. So thank you. On behalf of the board, staff and the school community, I would like to pay a special tribute to our staff who are leaving us this year, after many years of service to Hamilton Girls High School. To Joanna Dickinson, Yelena, I'm going to give this a go, Yelena Blagovic, Jennifer Finihau, and Alan Jones from the hostel. And lastly, but certainly not least, to Mrs. Josephine Mapleston. Josephine is leaving our school after 32 years. She has been a teacher for a whole lot longer than that. She started off as an assistant teacher, moving on to assistant of English and social studies. She has also taught geography, journalism, and media studies. And in 2003, she was appointed as head of department of social science and teacher in charge of media studies. Can I please ask Mrs. Josephine Mapleston to come up on stage? Josephine, we thank you for your commitment to our kura and we wish you well in your retirement. Thanks is never enough for the work that you have given us. Caregivers and school community, thank you for choosing to send your daughters to Hamilton Girls High School. We thank you for your continued partnership, support and encouragement, from ensuring your daughters are engaged in their learning, to taking pride in how they look, to turning up to school in the correct uniform and with the right equipment for their learning, to dropping them off and picking them up from training and school events. Thank you for your commitment and thank you for your support. I would also like to pay a special tribute to all the parents who have coached, managed, travelled, cooked, cleaned and fundraised to get our students to events and competitions. Without you, none of those would be possible. For many of you, this will be the final prize giving you'll be attending for Hamilton Girls High School. Facing the dreaded farewells as your daughters prepare to fly the nest and your family dynamics about to change forever. Rest assured, there have been many parents who have been here before you and they have all survived and adapted to the changes. Our children were only loaned to us for a short time and we can only try our best to bring up these young people to be the best versions of adults we want them to be. To all our outgoing students and student leaders, thank you for your leadership and service to our kura and to our Year 12s, who will be appointed as next year's Executive Council and Prefects. Embrace every moment of the next 12 months. Time flies. Our outgoing student leaders and whānau will attest to that. Turn the lessons learnt into opportunities and be positive influence to all that is good. To all our girls leaving our kura at the end of this year, years of dedication, perseverance, and sacrifice have brought you to this moment. And you should be incredibly proud of yourselves and feel confident that the skills and education you've learnt along the way are valuable, vital, and will serve you well into the next stage of your life. You are all young, healthy, smart, talented, ambitious, and exceptional human beings who are surrounded by people who love and support you the most. Your graduation from high school is an amazing accomplishment and one you should take pride in achieving. I wish you all the best in your final exams and your last farewells. Thank you all for joining us tonight, and I wish you a wonderful evening and a happy holiday season. Nā reira, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā tātou katoa. Kia munuina.
Thank you, Carissa. Te hei mauri ora, ki te whai au, ki te ao marama, he kupu tuatahi maku ki te atua, nana nei, nā mea katoa. Tuarua, ki te arikanui kweni, nā waihono e te pō, me te whare kahui araki, whānui tonu, pai marire. E nā mati, o ea marae, o ea hapu, o ea iwi, haere, haere, haere atu rā. E nā iwi, e nā reo, e nā mana, tēnā koutou kua tai mai nei ki te manaaki e te kaupapa o te rā. Nō reira, nō mai, whakatau mai. I extend a very warm welcome to our chairperson, Carissa McKay, Board of Trustees, distinguished guests, staff, students, parents, caregivers, and extended whānau, and thank you all for your contribution to our place. 2024 has been a stellar year with many outstanding events to celebrate the achievements of our young wahine. Tonight is an opportunity to acknowledge, to recognise, to reflect, to inspire, to aspire, and to learn from those around you. For our Year 13 students, this is possibly the last page of a memorable chapter in your life. This year, I was very privileged to win a sabbatical award for 10 weeks, of which I travelled to visit schools in Melbourne, London, Dublin, and Singapore. It allowed me to gain a snapshot of a variety of schools, but in particular, two stood out for me. The first, Mulberry School for Girls, located in Whitechapel, London, is an oversubscribed, highly ambitious school with a commitment to social justice. They serve families whose children experience some of the highest rates of child poverty in the UK. Most families live in overcrowded social housing, yet serious social and financial disadvantage does not hold the school back. The rigour of their curriculum and approach to learning and teaching is extremely high, which expects the best achievement from all students and staff. 98% of the pupils at Mulberry School are practising Muslims, most of whom are of British Bangladeshi heritage. Over the past 15 years, the Muslim community experienced significant turbulence with extremism and community division since Brexit, combining to make it difficult for inner London pupils, especially Muslim girls, to traverse. Breaking down external stereotypical attitudes towards their school community is a challenge, but one where staff build strong relationships with their students to bring out the best in them. The second, Michaela School in Wembley, London, also serves an underprivileged community. A charter school and recognised as a trailblazer for schools that walk every word they talk. They are different. To use their words, they make tradition fashionable. They work hard and persevere. They love to celebrate kindness and gratitude, and they take on challenges and jump over obstacles. They make a difference so that one day they can look back at their lives and know it was worth it. The teachers in this school describe themselves as tiger teachers, giving poor children access to knowledge, rigour, testing and competition. At Michaela, the teacher is always teaching and leading from the front, where the adults don't try to be friends with the kids, but instead are in charge with a sense of authority, insisting on high standards of behaviour. Catherine Birbal-Singh, headmaster, states clearly that they have a culture at Michaela that would have been perfectly normal in 1955, but highly controversial in 2024. Bringing this back to HGHS, what were my learnings? A relational culture must be at the core of all we do and should be the primary means of influence. We should teach young people before we teach subjects. We should teach them to be human before we teach them skills and knowledge. We should teach them to have educated hearts as well as educated minds. In Aotearoa, New Zealand, and overseas, we have seen many examples of well-educated leaders with no conscience or compassion. The nature of that relational culture is reciprocal between students and staff, but young people need the first modelling in a school environment to come from our staff, to understand the importance of whakawhanaungatanga and how we embed this in our pedagogy. There were many learnings from my sabbatical, but also gratitude. Thank you to Craig Scrimmager for leading the school in my absence, and a big thank you to Deputy Principals Victoria Trenwith, Susie Brace, Campbell Wood and Gronya O'Mahony, and Acting Assistant Principal Ronya Scandera. Special thanks to Finance Manager Paula McEwen, Property Manager Norm Jordan and Director of Boarding Tony Solomon, and all teaching and support staff. I do want to finish with sharing some words of wisdom to our students from those who stood where you stand now, the voices of past head girls and deputy head girls who walked where you have walked, worn our uniform, and like you, dreamed about their future. They've faced challenges, celebrated successes, and left their mark on our school. And although they have gone on to new chapters in their lives, their messages hold powerful lessons for all of you. Latara Allen, head girl in 2017, shared with us that one of the most important lessons she learnt while at Girls High is diversity matters. What connects Girls High girls together is the shared exposure to people from different backgrounds, which is so crucial in our ever globalised society that we live in. When you're put in a classroom of people from four different religions, 10 ethnicities, and several different economic backgrounds, you are forced to think outside yourself. This is a privilege. This forces us to be global citizens. Latara continued to add that this offers our girls a beyond the text and beyond yourself look at life. Her final words, school is here to equip us for our futures, but it is the people that we grow and learn with that ultimately inspires us. In September 2024, Latara was named Miss Samoa and continues to share her messages as a global citizen. Jasmine Hotham, Deputy Head Girl 2018, gave a piece of inspiring advice to those beginning their sporting journey. Treasure every moment you have playing school sport because it doesn't last forever. Sing as loud as you can in your bus rides. Dance between games and enjoy every match like it's your last because you never know, it actually might be for a little while. She also shared with us her very heartfelt experience of her life-changing injury and the challenge of rising above this. In her words, when life throws you in the water of adversity, how can you turn the situation into an opportunity to learn and grow? Each experience is a building block, and every step forward will bring you closer to discovering who you are. After a roller coaster of sporting highs and lows, we were extremely excited and privileged to see Jasmine Hotham gain a gold medal at the Olympics in Paris for Rugby Sevens in 2024. Jaden Randall, head girl in 2018, shared in his speech that she leaves HGHS with the experience that helped shape her thinking, the knowledge of how to work harder and smarter and to finally create her own tomorrow, because your destiny lies in the choices you make and the relationships you create. Jaden came back to HGHS as a first-year teacher in Te Reo and Music in 2023, but she created her own tomorrow and chose to follow her dream in music this year. As we have heard, we were excited to follow her journey of making the finals for The Voice in Australia, which has now opened up doors for her in Melbourne. Ruby Moitara, head girl 2020, shared in her speech that leadership is an attitude and a choice, not a badge and a title. A badge and a title merely acknowledges the qualities that a person exhibits, but everyone has the capabilities of being a leader. Leadership is about seeing people and using your mana to enhance that of others, to raise up other leaders amongst, almost like a gardener nurturing their flowers. Leadership mustn't stop at us, it must continue to grow. She also stated that it's okay to ask for help. In 2024, Ruby is following her dream of being a primary school teacher and loves going to school every day, no doubt inspiring those around her. Rebecca Yuan, Head Girl 2022, reminds us of our school values of curiosity and courage. Curiosity, as learners, we must always ask ourselves, how can I grow? How can I use these learnings to guide me into a stronger person? To always seek new experiences and continue to flourish. Our value of courage allows us to recall why we started in the first place, to remember what initially motivated us to pursue the journeys we are on, as this can give us the courage and fortitude to endure whatever challenges and hardships which may come our way. In 2024, Rebecca Yuan is a film production student at the University of Southern California and an award-winning New Zealand filmmaker. Creating captivating films that resonate with her international audience drives her, and she takes pride in her diverse background. These head students are amazing. They've each left a legacy of courage, resilience, kindness, and curiosity at HGHS, and we are very proud of them. To our leavers, our year nine COVID babies, over your 5 years, you will have absorbed not only information, knowledge, and skills, but also our school's value, culture, and history. As you walk out our gates for the last time, take that experience and use it to make a difference in the world. E hara takitoa e te toa takatai, engari he toa takatini. Our strength is not made from us alone, but made from many. We're stronger together. Nō reira, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou katoa.
Kia ora, Ed Whānau. I feel like I've been throwing a hospital pass here, having to follow an act like that. I'm not going to sing for you, though. All right, my name's Craig Scrimger, Deputy Principal. It's my pleasure to announce the first awards category, which recognises Year 11 students for distinction and subject-specific awards. To be awarded with distinction, a student must perform at a high level academically and place within the top 5% of their cohort for a given program. Subject-specific cups are for top performers, in particular learning programs such as top in a subject. The Year 11 Deans, Mr. Caleb McCullum and Ms. Tyler Horton, will be presenting the awards. Winners will be announced in groups. Please hold your applause until each group is on stage. Right, the following groups of students receive a distinction award in one subject. Kate Anderson, Money Smart Business. Gianna Aston, English Visual. Lily Baker, History. Ivy Brinkworth, Science. Isabella Bunyan, Mathematics with Statistics. Yuen Cheng, Mathematics. He's unable to attend this evening. Imogen Clulo, English. Michelle Clutie, Advanced Physical Education. Congratulations. Keely Daniels, Money Smart Business. Elise Davis, Health. Summer Delaney, Mathematics and Statistics with Algebra. Ella Duthie, Work and Study Skills. Phoebe Gibson receives the Bev Little Memorial Cup for Mathematical Diligence in Year 11. Shelley Scudsell, Art Practical. Lila Gunn, Technology, Design and Visual Communication. Sienna Herbert, Mathematics and Statistics with Algebra. Congratulations. Chawson Hook, Science. Maya Horn, Mathematics and Statistics with Algebra. Belle Horsley, Mathematics and Statistics with Algebra. Riley Johnson, Money Smart Business. Aisha Kamaldeen, Science, unable to attend this evening. Adrian Longard, Music. Paige Mooker, Hospitality. Eli Morgan, Commerce. Congratulations. Marisha O'Neill, Health. Cassia Pace, English. Meadow Park, Mathematics and Statistics. Abby Pell, Dance. Jasmine Rear, Advanced Physical Education. Ardra Rajesh, English. Matt Ricketts, Money Smart Business. Ashika Robin, Health. Congratulations. Caitlin Ross, English. Arantxa Sable, English. Zara Yasmin, Hospitality. Dana Savage, Hospitality. Bailey Smith, Mathematics with Statistics, and she's unable to attend this evening. Yuki Takahashi, Commerce. Elise Tainakori, Salter, Art Practical. She's unable to attend this evening. Kale Torpia Chesley, Te Reo Māori. Congratulations. Angel Tutungia Unga, Study and Vocational Literacy. Willow Tullock, Science and Society. She's unable to attend this evening. Bernardi Wijay Surya, English. She's unable to be here as well. Christel Wolfart, Commerce. Jane Zahn, Science. Gracie Zoe, Science. Congratulations. Okay, the following group of students receive a distinction award in two subjects. Katie Abbott, Commerce and Science. Razan Al Amarin, Mathematics and Statistics with Algebra and Technology Food. Lily Allen, Mathematics and Statistics with Algebra and the Southern Hospitality Award for Outstanding Work in Year 11 Hospitality. Savannah Amos, English Visual, Science and Society. Sophia Bankers, Drama, Spanish. Sasha Belfield, Digital Art, Science. Congratulations. Akritri Bhandari, English as an Additional Language in Science and Society. Ivy Brunskill, Drama, History. Sophia Dimitrico, Science, Technology, Soft Materials. Emily Dudley, English, IGCSE, and Media Studies. Neva Easthope Gay, Social Studies and Language Perfect Champion. Fitu Kiradauri Muru, Active Wellbeing, Te Reo Māori. Congratulations. Arbida Hidari, English Language Foundation, and the Language Institute Cup for Outstanding Progress. Vaya Havaya, English Pacifica Cultural Studies. Ruby Haysom, History, Mathematics with Statistics. Nishimi Herath Moody Yag Sailaje, English Workplace Computing. Ella Marshall, Advanced Physical Education, English. Georgia McGregor, Food and Nutrition and Technology Food. Congratulations. Mia Neil Sorensen, Art Practical and Global Studies. Duzelle Wing, English Visual, Distinction in Level 2 English for Academic Purposes. Alyssa Sock, Mathematics IGCSE and Science IGCSE. Yantami Tolko, English, Mathematics with Statistics, and she's unable to attend this evening. Greer Wilson, English, Science and Society. Francesca Slotkoska Eddy, English, top in NCA Level 1 English. Congratulations. The following students receive a distinction award in three subjects: Luca Barker, Commerce, Mathematics IGCSE, and Media Studies. Pew Chit, History, Technology, Design and Visual Communication, and she receives the Ruth Rainsford Memorial Cup for Excellence in Year 11 Art. Annika Douglas Carr, Active Wellbeing, Mathematics with Statistics, top in NCA Level 1 Mathematics and Statistics. Taylor Hasty, French, History, Science. Lucy Jamieson, Advanced Physical Education, English, Science. Congratulations. And for the last group, the following students receive a distinction award in four subjects: Lynn Lee, Mathematics IGCSE, Technology, Design and Visual Communication. She receives the Collins Cup for Mathematics in Year 11 and the Year 11 English Cup. Maya Tricky, Geography, Mathematics with Statistics, and she receives the Finlay Cup for Geography in Year 11 and the Jackson Keats Trophy for Outstanding Achievement in Media Studies. And Dasuli Senyumika, Japanese, Science, and the Daph Pinkney Cup for Achievement in Senior Japanese and top in NCA Level 1 Science. Congratulations. That concludes the Year 11 awards. Miss O'Mahony will announce the Year 12 awards, and the Year 12 Dean, Miss Kathleen Christian, will present the awards. Kia ora.
Kia ora. My name is Gráinne O'Mahony, and it's my pleasure to read the Year 12 awards this evening. Year 12 and NCA Level 2 is a key academic milestone in a student's high school pathway. It is fantastic to be able to recognize so many top performers today. Once again, as I call students forward to receive their distinction and subject awards, I'll be announcing them in groups. Ms. Christian will be presenting the awards. Please hold your applause until each group is on stage. The following groups of students receive a distinction award in one subject. For legal studies, Maya Aitken, who's unable to be with us this evening. In active well-being, Sharna Asiata Fiasi. In business studies, Tavia Bai. In health, Caitlin Ball. For science, Aliana Bantigo. For art painting, Liv Bredenbeck. For Pacifica cultural studies, Leila Darua. For advanced physical education sport, Charlotte Davey. And in business studies, Maya Davey. Congratulations, girls. In active well-being, Bianca Dixon Kawana. For work and study skills, Zanada Duplessis. In active well-being, Maria Elkington. in active well-being, Nevea Whaeaonga Pa'alunu. For early childhood education, Sam Faulkner. In English visual, Hazel Ferguson. For tourism, Kiva Fruin. In global studies, Kyla George. And for design and visual communication, Zara Graham. Well done. In mathematics, Georgia Healy. For social studies, Ria Hopa, who's unable to be with us this evening. For mathematics, Sandali Imalia. In tourism, Riley Jeffries, who is absent. For mathematics, Devon Jones. In English, Sukman Kaur. For dance, Natalie Keezing Kerrison. And in mathematics, Mihi Kerr. Congratulations. For study and vocational numeracy, Caitlin Napper, who I believe is absent this evening. In science, Alice Lavakeho. In music, Caitlin Lee. In biology, Kalunia Malua. In business studies, Alice McCartney. And for tourism, Michaela McFarlane. For mathematics with calculus, Amina Muhammad. And for early childhood education, Lean Nusser. Well done, ladies. For biology, Vasu Parma. In art photography, Krishna Patel. For English, Savannah Patuway. Also in English, Holly Proudlock. For business studies, Navreet Rana, who's absent this evening. For workplace computing, Emma Routon. In history, Jordan Shaw. and in study and vocational communication, Taylor Skelton. Congratulations. For art printmaking, Jade Snapes. In mathematics, Shrian Takdoy. In Te Reo Māori, Awarua Twidal. In advanced physical education outdoors, Sophia van den Bogard. In science, Marika Funnykirk. The New Zealand School of Tourism Award, Angela Vong. And in food and nutrition, Olivia Walker. Well done. The following groups of students receive a distinction award in two subjects. For agribusiness studies and mathematics with statistics, Caitlin Allen. For art photography and soft materials technology, Sienna Deviney. In chemistry and physics, Karenza Ali. For mathematics with calculus and Spanish, Jumana Fuda. In hospitality and the Southern Hospitality Award, Alice Lee. And in English and geography, Stephanie Lopez. Congratulations. For advanced physical education outdoors and the Waikato Polytechnic Cup, Bella McCarthy. In English and food technology, Taylor Millen. For early childhood education and hospitality, Isla Murray. For chemistry and early childhood education, Kari Nolan. For drama and performance music, River Park. And in accounting and English, Ella Payne. Well done, everybody. In mathematics and the Photo Life Graphic Arts Award, Haley Pa. In art design and English, Anya Ray. In English and digital technology, Zakea Irene Reyes. In biology and English, Elliot Rolton. For Level 3 Te Reo Māori and the Te Rangitahi Cup, Desire Tawa. In Mathematics and Tourism, Emma Whiteley. Congratulations. The following students receive a distinction award in three subjects. For English, History, and Money Smart Business, Catherine Benton. In English, Japanese, and Mathematics with Calculus, Haley Jorgensen. In English, Mathematics and Physics, Piyamdi Mataku Darachi. Well done. The final group of Year 12 students receive a distinction award in five subjects. For classical studies, drama, media studies, social studies, and the Jude Young Cup, and the Justine Cameron Memorial Cup, Sam Clooney. For biology, chemistry, French, mathematics with calculus, the Hayworth Cup, and the Middleton Chemistry Cup, Amy Edwards. For biology, chemistry, English Extension, physics, the Alison Hodder Cup and the Kearns Cup, Bianca Slomp. Congratulations again. That concludes the Year 12 Awards. We will now enjoy a musical performance from Bella Sinfonia before head girl Paige McConey gives her final address and the Year 13 Awards are announced.
What a magnificent performance. Let's give them another round of applause. This year's head girl has led with enthusiasm and poise. She has embodied our school values, encouraging her fellow students at Hamilton Girls to make the most of their opportunities that come their way and to give of their all. It's my pleasure to invite Paige McConey forward to give her valedictory address.
Tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou katoa. Hello and a warm welcome to you all here tonight. My name is Paige McConey and it is my absolute honour to stand before you all for my final address as your head girl for 2024. And it is an honour to join you in celebrating the successes of our incredible young wahine at tonight's Senior Prizegiving. The sun has begun its descent below 2024's horizon and will soon rise for a new dawn in its own right, inviting renewed passions, wonder, and determination. But as we sit here connected in this space, in the face of this metaphorical sunset, I invite us all to reflect. To quote one of my personal favorite songs, "This world is changing so fast and I have to follow." Change can be hard, yet we still endure it. Growing and changing are in fact some of life's most beautiful gifts. We all too often forget to look back and see how much change has occurred in our lives, and we all too often forget to appreciate those moments. Sometimes I wish I could sit down with my anxious year nine self and shake her shoulders and tell her it's going to be okay. Tell her that she is going to be okay. She will find peace and love and friends that genuinely care for her. Tell her that she is valid, that her feelings and emotions are valid. But unfortunately, none of the incredible science girls have invented time travel yet, so I will instead figuratively shake your shoulders and tell you, it's going to be okay. You are going to be okay. You will find peace, love, and people who truly, genuinely care about you. You are valid. Your feelings and emotions are valid. Allow yourself to feel. It is such a gift that we are able to feel everything so deeply. Please allow yourself to feel. Few things are destined to last, most are gone tomorrow. You don't quite realize how true those words are until you can count down the remaining days left of high school on your fingers. But to my dearest friends, and to the familiar faces I pass each day, I can assure you that no matter where we end up, no matter how far we grow apart, our roots will be forever connected through the time we've spent here together, through our laughter, tears, and every moment in between. So when I leave, as I must do, a part of me stays here with you, and I'm glad a part of me will, forever connected to you all, and what a blessing that is. Change and growth are completely impossible to achieve on your own, and I have been so lucky to grow alongside so many wonderful people whom I owe my world to. First and foremost, to the five girls who have been my absolute rocks throughout this year, Sina, Elise, Gracie, Toya, and Katie, my sisters. There are not enough words to describe how grateful I am for these girls. You inspire me every single day. From your unapologetic sense of self, your care, and your empathy, I have been forever changed by you all. You have made me a better person and have shown me unwavering support and belief in me, even when I couldn't find it in myself. Miss Gordon, Miss Nightingale, and the entirety of the senior leadership team, thank you for everything that you've done. From bringing my crazy ideas back down to earth and shaping them into something a little bit more realistic, or listening to every issue, big and small, over a lunchtime catch-up, learning from you all and working alongside you has taught me so much. Most notably, that you are all just grown-up teenagers. Mr. Scrimmager, most notably. But seriously, I am so grateful for the support you selflessly give, not only to the Executive Council, but to all the students here at Kura. We're so lucky to have you all. We're equally lucky to have our teaching staff. There have been so many of you that have had such an impact on my life, shaping me into the best version of myself and continuously pushing me to achieve the best I can. Miss Kenny, Miss Palmer, Mr. Burkers, and Miss Horton in particular, thank you. Not only have you had to deal with me through the chaos that was this year, you all create such a safe environment in your classroom. Your classes feel like home when home feels like too much. The way you bring your students together is simply magic. Thank you for backing me, even when nobody else did. And if I grow up to have even the slightest bit of your kindness, empathy, wit, or knowledge on hiking and camping gear, Mr. Burkers, please never stop getting excited about that stuff. I'll be beyond satisfied. And to all the girls in these classes, you don't understand how much you mean to me. Thank you for creating such a safe space to learn, grow, laugh, and make mistakes. Every girl deserves people like you in their life. And finally, from within the school, there are two absolute stunners who I can't go without thanking. Charlotte and I met in year four, and I have been so blessed to grow up alongside her and watch her become such a kind, caring, strong woman. Charlotte, you are capable of so much, and you deserve the world 10 times over. And to the pain in my backside, the Irish devil on my shoulder, the friend I could never shake no matter how hard I tried, Georgia, you've seen me in my trenches and I've seen you in yours. At the best of times and the worst of times, you have never failed to stay right by my side, and I could not be more grateful for the love you've given me over the years. But the last of my thanks goes to my parents, my ma and pa. I'd be nothing without you, literally. But I'd be nothing without the support you've given me throughout my life. From age four with the constant dress-up and living room concerts you had to endure, to my angsty phase in year 10, through till now. I love you, and thank you for believing in me. But to my mum especially, thank you for your laughter. I think some of my favourite memories are of us sitting on the couch, well past bedtime, doubled over in fits of laughter about one thing or another, breaking out a whiteboard to draw up nonsense graphs that no mathematician could ever begin to understand. Singing, dancing, crying, binge-watching really, really atrocious Christmas movies. It is those small moments that mean the most to me. You make me so proud to be your girl. I see you in my hands, in the way I make my art, in the way that I smile, and the way that I cry when Bing Bong dies in Inside Out. I love you the mostest of the most. And unfortunately, there wasn't enough time in the schedule tonight to accommodate for your solo. Hate to disappoint. I know we were all looking forward to it. I like to think of myself as a words girl, hence why it took me 3 months to finalize this speech. But I'd like to close off my final address with a poem that is very near and dear to my heart. Wild Geese by Mary Oliver. You do not have to be good. You do not have to walk on your knees for 100 miles through the desert repenting. You only have to let the soft animal of your body love what it loves. Tell me about despair, yours, and I will tell you mine. Meanwhile, the world goes on. Meanwhile, the sun and the clear pebbles of rain are moving across the landscapes, over the prairies and deep trees, mountains and the rivers. Meanwhile, the geese, high in the clean blue air, are heading home again. Whoever you are, no matter how lonely, the world offers itself to your imagination, calls to you like the wild geese, harsh and exciting, over and over announcing your place in the family of things. This poem has been a reminder that no matter who you are, you belong, you are loved, seen, and valued in the great family of things in this world. So please, I implore you all to continue to announce your place in this world. Take up space in this world. Please do take up space. As young women, we are not made to be small and quiet, especially all of you here in this room tonight. You all have the drive, capability, and passion to change the world. Truly, you do. Feel the fire in your belly and use it to fuel change, to fuel growth. This world is changing so fast, but you have the power to change it for good. Take up space. Revel in the glory of the world and remember that you are a part of it. All the love in the world. Nō reira, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā tātou katoa. Thank you.
Thank you, Paige. Kia ora, my name is Mrs. Victoria Trenwith, the Deputy Principal aligned with Year 13. Our final year level awards category recognises our graduating senior students. For many, Year 13 marks the conclusion of a 5-year journey at secondary school and is the culmination of a student's high school career. With this in mind, we are very proud as a school to be acknowledging a fantastic group of students who have achieved academic excellence and gained subject prizes this year. To all winners, I give you my heartfelt congratulations. Mrs. Sadhana Debakta, your Year 13 Dean, will present the awards. As students come forward in groups, please hold your applause until each group is on stage. The following group of students receive a distinction award in one subject. Jade Angeles, Mathematics. Monique Austin, History. Zoe Bacall, English. Mishka Kajiat, English. Becky Kempkin, History. Shelley Foster, the Melissa Massey Cup. And Lizzie Hall with the Waikato Trades Academy Prize. Congratulations. Ruby Inia, Hospitality. Libby Jones, Mathematics. Olivia Rose Kowa, Dance. Lily Loveridge, English, In Absentia. Tatiana Mataua, the Julie Small Cup. Lucy Mills, Agribusiness Studies. Angelique Mudasumbwa, Global Studies. Well done. Jira Murray, Performance Music. Senator Pacifica Cultural Studies. Pilot Paraha Senior, Advanced Physical Education Shield. In absentia, Ella Petrie with the Prize for Early Childhood Education. Caitlin Porter, French. Gloria Podgita, Business Studies. And receiving the Waikato Polytechnic Cup, Zara Rattray. Congratulations, ladies. Eva Saxton, Social Studies. Jaden Smith receives the Wilcock Cup. In absentia, we acknowledge Rhiannon Smith with an English prize, and I welcome forward Nathalie Stark for a prize for art painting. Lizelle Stoles, art design. Kiana Such, Japanese. Caitlin Tamatia Kepa, active wellbeing. Yay! Let's give them a round of applause. Waniva Tautalanoa, active wellbeing. Ella Toogood, the Lily Award. Georgia Vitti, Classical Studies. Angela Vong, Tourism. And the Anne Kitto Memorial Cup is awarded to Kin Zor. Congratulations. The following group of students receive a distinction award in two subjects. Abigail Rain Ariz, Technology, Digital, and the Julie Capel Memorial Cup. Bruna Correa Campos receives a prize for Spanish and the Don Quixote Prize. In absentia, Riley Coyle is awarded prizes for business studies and mathematics. Laura D'Souza, advanced physical education, sport and hospitality. Thank you. Kira Marks, art printmaking and tourism. Unable to be with us this evening, Drishti Sharma for business studies and mathematics. And likewise, Rihanna Tolbo, receiving awards for art photography and English visual. We welcome forward Femke Wiley for advanced physical education outdoors and the Adventurers Cup. Well done. The following students receive a distinction award in three subjects. Casey Chow, English, Mathematics with Statistics, and the Statistics Cup. In absentia, Claire Cruz for Food and Nutrition, Technology Design, and Visual Communication, along with the Crystal Trophy. We welcome forward Bree Delaney for Classical Studies, Drama, and the Senior Speech Award. Rosie Fenner, Technology Soft Materials, the Design Enterprise Award, and the Award for Fashion Design. In absentia, Lily Hoban, receiving Technology Food, the Waikato Culinary Award, and the Year 13 Catering and Hospitality Cup. And it's my pleasure to welcome forward Tia Merrilees for awards in Biology, Chemistry, and Mathematics with Calculus. Juana Romera, for Business Studies, Science, and Social Studies. And Hashani Sadisi Amanda for Biology, Chemistry, and English. Let's congratulate these students. The following student receives a distinction award in four subjects. Megan McInnes receives awards for geography, mathematics with calculus, the Louise Turner Cup, and the New Zealand Geographic Society Cup. And the following student receives a distinction award in five subjects, Evelyn Anderson Wharekura, for accounting, biology, chemistry, physics, and the accounting cup. Let's give Evelyn a round of applause. We'll applaud each of the next two students individually. The following student receives a distinction award in six subjects. Grace Craig, English Extension, History, Media Studies, the Dave Hewitt Cup, the Mapleston Award, and the Penny Pollard Cup. Well done, Grace. I think we should get her to stand here and have her moment, hey? Yeah, omaiti paki paki. Well done, Grace. And the following student receives a distinction award in eight subjects. It's my great pleasure to welcome forward Nisha Moorfield, who receives awards in biology, classical studies, music, physics, the Classics Cup, the Excite Trust Science Award, the Gail Bergman Biology Cup, and the Patricia Campbell Cup. Yay, Nisha! That brings us to the end of our Year 13 awards. Our Principal, Ms. Gordon, will now acknowledge our 2024 student leaders, and these awards will be presented by our Board of Trustees Chairperson, Carissa McKay. Thank you.
Thank you, Mrs. Trenwith. Student leadership plays an important role at Hamilton Girls High School and is often the essential ingredient required to drive many of the wonderful initiatives we are able to offer. This year, our prefects and house captains have led capably with enthusiasm and integrity in a variety of different capacities in our school. Being a student leader requires bravery, character, and a can-do attitude. Our leaders were organised and served on a range of different leadership councils and groups, ensuring we could provide great opportunities to the wider student body. It is my pleasure to recognise their service to our kura. Students will be called up by their prefect councils or student leadership groups. Please hold your applause until each group has joined me on stage. The Academic Council. Business Prefect, Millie Jamieson. Libby Jones, English Prefect. Our Gate Prefect, Sihanza Soizia, is absent this evening. Our Learning Support Prefect, Livy Bailey. Languages Prefect, Becky Kempkin. Mathematics Prefect, Megan McInnes. PE and Health Prefect, Laura D'Souza. Our Science Prefect, Nisha Moorfield. Social Science Prefect, Caitlin Mookie. Technology Prefect, Lily Hoban. She's unable to attend this evening. And the Arts Prefect, Gloria Podgita, who's also absent this evening. Congratulations to our Academic Council. Our Arts Council. Dance Prefect, Olivia Rose Kowa. Debating Prefect, Anna Alston. She's an absentia. Drama Prefect, Bree Delaney. Our Toi Māori Prefect, and always a smile on her face, Arahia Gage. Media Prefect Zoe Bickle. Music Prefect Cassie Chow. Our Visual Arts Prefect Shine Labours. And our Pacifica Arts Prefect, the one and only Waniva Tuta Lanoa. Congratulations to our Arts Council. Services Council, Community Prefect Latisha Teng. Our Diversity Prefect Tanya Davidze. International Prefect Tanisha Prasad. Our Kawatea Prefect Madeline Allery. Our Library Prefect Brianna Laird. Our Pacifica Prefect Anakyu Tenefufu Manasi. Congratulations to our Services Council. Sports Council. Our Sports Council Prefects are Sienna Austin, who is absent this evening, Rihanna Brewer, Sophia Hall, Caitlin Hull, who is in absentia, and Ruby Hart. Congratulations to our Sports Council. Our Sonning Hill Council, Caitlin Hull, who's absent this evening, Cerise Fong, Sonning Hill Prefect, Ruby Hart, Maddie Mulgrew, thank you to the Executive Council from Sonning Hill Hostel for your work. Thank you. Our House Leaders, Campbell House, Jordan Devoy. Edgecombe House, Naya Nico. Heads House, Zara Rattray. McDiarmid House, Pilot Senior. Wilson House, Aria Passi. Congratulations to our House Leaders, thank you. I would like to invite this year's Executive Council Prefects and the Head Girl of Sonning Hill Hostel 4 to be acknowledged for their leadership this year and to present also this evening the Executive Council for 2025. If I can invite on stage Paige McConey, Sina, Onesa Moatoa, Latoya Haimona, Elise Paki, Gracie Kerr and Caitlin Tamatea Kepa. I'd like to thank them for being an outstanding Executive Council. They've come together as a group right from day one and have led the student cohort exceptionally well this year. And for that, I thank you. The 2025 Executive Council is an extremely competitive and rigorous process which decides our school executive council. This year, applicants have submitted a video application, were shortlisted by their peers, and were interviewed by a panel. Each prefect who has led in an executive council role this year will announce those who have been selected for their roles for the coming school year. And we're going to start with the head girl from hostel. Where are they? Executive Council 2024. Can you come up here, please? Tonight? Thank you.
Kia ora, ko Caitlin Tamatia toku ingoa. It is my pleasure to announce the 2025 Sonning Hill Hostel Head Girl. Sorry. Okay, 2025 Sonning Hill Hostel Head Girl is Ellie Child.
Hello, my name is Latoya Haimona. I'm the Academic Captain of 2024, and it is my pleasure to announce the Academic Captain of 2025. Just bear with me. Jumana Fowler?
My name is Elise Pucky and I'm your 2024 Arts Council Captain. And I'm so excited to announce that your 2025 Arts Council Captain is River Park.
It is my pleasure to announce the Service Council Captain for 2025 to, Alex McCarthy.
Hi, my name's Gracie Kerr. I've had the honour of serving as the 2024 Sports Captain. And your 2025 Sports Captain is Kamiley Haggie.
Next position to be announced is the Deputy Head Girl. It is my pleasure to announce the Deputy Head Girl for 2025 is... Jumana Fula!
Oh!
Kia ora everyone, my name is Paige McConey and it has been my absolute honour to serve as the head girl for 2024. The head girl's responsibility is to care for her girls, and maybe I have had a sneaky peek in here, and I can assure you all that the head girl for 2025 is absolutely perfect. Drum roll please for your head girl for 2025. Sophie Ahu!
Congratulations to our 2025 Executive Council. One more hand as I leave the count. We will now enjoy a musical item before Mr. Wood announces the special awards and the tertiary scholarship recipients.
Thank you.
Just well. Let's give her another round of applause. Kia ora koutou. My name is Mr. Campbell Wood, and it's my pleasure to acknowledge our special awards this evening. This category includes some of our most historic and prestigious cups, awards, and recognitions at Hamilton Girls. Recipients are acknowledged for a variety of reasons, including academic excellence, school service, citizenship, and for embodying the school values. Please hold your applause until each group is on stage. To begin with, the Rosemary Weatherhog Trophy for Head Girl and the Smithies Tray for the President of the Student Council, Paige McConey. The Deputy Head Girls Prize and the Service Captain's Cup, and the recipient also of the Mackie Johnston Optima Cup for all-round excellence, is awarded to Sina Toa. The Sonninghill Award for Leadership goes to a student who has given extraordinary service to the hostel over the years. She is positive, willing to go the extra mile, and an exceptional role model. She also receives the Sir Optimist International Youth Leadership Award, Caitlin Tamatia Kepa. For her service to academia within the school, Academic Captain's Cup is awarded to Latoya Haimona. For her service to arts within the school, Arts Captain's Cup is awarded to Elise Paki. And for her service to sport within the school, the R English Cup for sports captain goes to Gracie Kerr. Congratulations. The Old Girls, Auckland Old Girls Prize for Special Service to the School by a Day Student goes to Brianna Laird. The Global Citizenship Award to a student who has best promoted international relationships within the school to Lamar Abu Haza. The Gudex Memorial Prize for Languages is awarded to Vanshika Kapila. The H.D. Tate Award for a Year 11 student who has made a positive contribution to the school to Pew Chit. The Margaret Clark Sonning Award for a hostel student who has contributed the most to the school to Ruby Hart. The May Allen Scholarship for a Year 12 student who has made a positive contribution to the school goes to Alice McCartney. And the Middleton School Spirit Cup for a student who has contributed significantly to school spirit to Ilaria Pace. Well done. We recognise in absentia the recipient of the Mona Woods Prize, which is in recognition of extra effort made by a senior student from a non-English speaking background to achieve academic success, to Yuwin Chen. And we call forward the recipient of the Mullaney Award for service and loyalty to the school, to Waniva Tautalanoa. The Rotary Club of Waikato Sunrise Year 11 Cup and Prize for All-Round Excellence to Lynn Lee. And the Rotary Club of Waikato Sunrise Year 12 Cup and Prize for All-Round Excellence to Amy Edwards. The Tapakioni Skinner Taonga for contribution to biculturalism in the school is awarded to Arahia Gage.
Thanks, Mom.
The Te Tohu Tūmanako Award for contribution to Tikanga Māori at Hamilton Girls is awarded to Madeline Ellery. The Altruza Youth Award recognises a Year 12 student who has an excellent work ethic and helps out at school and in the wider community. And the Edith Collins Centennial Award for a student who has given great service to the school. And Executive Council Award for Excellence in Leadership, a recognition that is voted for by the outgoing Executive Council and presented to a Year 12 student who shows leadership potential. These three awards go to Jordan Shaw. Congratulations, ladies. Our last two awards of the special awards section are very special awards indeed. The Ducks Artium recognises the highest level of excellence across the co-curricular arts. Tonight we are proud to jointly award this to two worthy recipients who have both excelled in their chosen artistic disciplines. The first recipient is an outstanding performer in every way in her chosen discipline of dance. She held a leadership role in the dance department, having acted as dance captain this year, has provided choreography for our school production of Mamma Mia and for school dance troupes. This student has created strong relationships with peers and staff, has made her mark by continuously sharing her passion and dedication for arts and culture to the students and to the wider community. She exemplifies high achievement and excellence in her craft. In 2025, she takes her considerable skills to study dance at a prestigious tertiary level institution on a full scholarship. She is an outstanding role model for the arts and artistic achievement. The second recipient is a highly accomplished vocalist, guitarist, and dancer, and one of our CUDA's top performing music students in year 13. In 2024, she proved invaluable as a senior leader and mentor for vocal groups such as Manawahine, Uptown Girls, and also the 2024 production. She took on the significant principal role of Donna in Mamma Mia, not only carrying the demands of this pivotal role, but assisting with vocal coaching and mentoring of her fellow students. An accomplished vocalist across many styles, the student performs regularly in community groups, competitions, bands, and in lead roles as a member of the Rivoli and Morrinsville Theatre, exemplifying talent and dedication to the vocal arts. It's my absolute pleasure to congratulate the Ducks RTM for 2024, Olivia Rose Kowa and Jessica Wilde. Just ask you to remain on stage, ladies. The Dux Ludorum recognises the student who has obtained the highest level of sporting achievement. They are a role model and have shown leadership in their chosen sports, contributing positively to the school. This recipient has an impressive list of accolades and accomplishments beside their name. They have shone on both the national and international stage in their primary code of athletics, gaining a gold medal in the girls' under 18 400 metre hurdles at the Oceania Championships in Fiji. Further to this, the recipient was named in the New Zealand under 18 athletics team, placed third in the 400 metre hurdles at the Australian National Athletics Champs, and at the New Zealand Athletics Champ, she placed first in the under 18 300 metre hurdles, 4x400 metre relay, second in the 100 metre hurdles, and third in the triple jump. The recipient has achieved multiple other podium finishes at New Zealand Secondary Schools, North Island Secondary Schools, and YBOP Athletics Champs. She was the Senior Athletics and Cross Country Champion for 2024. Congratulations, Dux Ludorum for 2024, to Zara Rattray. Well done, ladies. Congratulations again to all Special Awards recipients. It's now my absolute pleasure to present the Tertiary Study Awards and University Scholarships gained by our Year 13 graduates. The following students have earned recognition for their efforts in trades courses or financial contributions towards their study and training post-secondary school. I will be announcing a group of students who have won scholarships to the University of Waikato shortly, but first I will invite forward those who have earned commendation from other campuses. For excellence in construction from the Waikato Trades Academy, Cadence Kipper. We recognise in absentia for excellence in cafe skills from the Waikato Trades Academy, Mia Vidoviak. And call for two recipients of the Outward Bound Wai Ora Scholarship. $5,000 has enabled two students to travel to Anakiwa in the Marlborough Sounds to attend a 21-day Outward Bound course to Pearl Tarai. And Cecilia Toto Inguoana. Two recipients of the David Johnston Charitable Trust Scholarship, $6,000. Congratulations to Vanshika Kapila. And Nathalie Stark. Congratulations. the University of Otago 150 entrance scholarship, $17,500, Hishani Amanda. The University of Otago Pacific Peoples Entrance Scholarship, also $17,500, Sina Toa. The University of Otago Vice Chancellor's Scholarship, $19,500, Caitlin Porter. And the Go Waitaha Canterbury, University of Canterbury, $15,000 scholarship, Rihanna Hill. Congratulations, ladies. The Tangiwai Excellence Scholarship, $5,000 from the University of Victoria, Paige McConey. The Totowika Equity Scholarship, $5,000 from the University of Victoria, Kira Sutherland. Well done, ladies. The University of Victoria Tangiwai Excellence Scholarship, $5,000, and the University of Auckland 140th Anniversary Academic Scholarship, $5,000, Bree Delaney. The University of Auckland Academic Potential Scholarship, $10,000, Nisha Moorfield. The University of Auckland Top Achiever Scholarship, $25,000, Evelyn Anderson Wharekura. Also a recipient of the University of Auckland Top Achiever Scholarship, Adriana Katoa. Also a recipient of the Top Achiever Scholarship from the University of Auckland and the University of Otago's Vice Chancellor's Scholarship, $19,500, Tia Merilis. The Tangiwai Excellence Scholarship, University of Victoria, $5,000, and the Top Achiever Scholarship from the University of Auckland to Ella Togut. The AUT Accommodation Scholarship, $12,000, Peta Kingi. And the Welcome to Auckland Scholarship, $24,000, welcome indeed, to Cassie Chow. O mai te paki paki. To the University of Waikato Scholarships now. Each year we have a large number of students who win monetary awards towards study at the university or tertiary institution of their choice, and this year is no exception. All up, our total awards earned for this year's cohort comes in at over $500,000. These scholarships assist in helping to unlock future educational opportunities that will profoundly impact lives. Every dollar is rightfully earned, both by the individuals we have just acknowledged and those who have earned scholarships to study at the University of Waikato. All up, the University of Waikato awards which our students have earned is over $250,000. I would now kindly invite Acting Deputy Vice-Chancellor Academic and Pro Vice-Chancellor Teaching and Learning Associate Professor Tracy Balfour to congratulate the recipients of the University of Waikato scholarships. There are 14 recipients of their Ko Te Tangata School Leavers Scholarship. We acknowledge in absentia Anna Alston and call forward Rihanna Brewer. Mishka Kagiat. Grace Craig. Madeline Ellery. We acknowledge in absentia Crystal Goodwin-Metz and call forward Latoya Haimona. Well done, ladies. Continuing to the second group of recipients for the Ko Te Tangata School Leavers Scholarship, Millie Jameson. Tia Miralees. Lucy Mills. We acknowledge in absentia Tariwa Murapakati and Asta Naya and call forward Hishani Amanda. And Kira Sutherland. Congratulations. The following student has won two scholarships to the University of Waikato. The Edna Money Future Pacific Leaders Scholarship, $18,000, and the Pacific Excellence Scholarship, $20,000. Congratulations to Serene Fakalelu. Give her another big round of applause. The following students have also won Premier Scholarship Awards. The Pacific Excellence Scholarship, Tanisha Prasad. And also a recipient of the Pacific Excellence Scholarship, Sina Toa. We have four recipients of the Te Paewae o Te Rangi Scholarship for Outstanding Academic Achievement, $30,000 to Becky Campkin, Arahia Gage, Megan McInnes, and Elise Paki.
Yeah, baby. Woo-hoo.
Congratulations. Thank you, Professor. That concludes our recognition for tertiary scholarships. Ms. Gordon will now announce the top academic honours awards.
Thank you, Mr. Wood. It is my pleasure to invite our board chairperson, Carissa McKay, forward to present our most prestigious awards for the evening, the Proximia Keset and the Academic Ducks. The Proximia Keset, runner-up to the Academic Ducks, received Academic Honours Awards for her outstanding results in both 2022 and 2023. She gained an excellence endorsement for both NCA Level 1 and 2, including three subject excellence endorsements in Year 12. She is on track to gain her NCA Level 3 with excellence in 2024. She has received a subject award for placing top in Year 13 English, History and Social Science, and a distinction award in three of her Year 13 subjects. Her academic achievements are noteworthy placing. First in Level 3 Media Studies, first equal in Level 3 English, first equal in Level 3 History, first equal in Level 3 Social Studies, second in Level 3 Classical Studies. It is my pleasure to announce the Proximia Keset for 2024 is Grace Craig. The final award of the evening is our Academic Ducks. The recipient received academic awards and honours for her outstanding results in both 2022 and 2023. She gained an excellent endorsement for both her NCA Level 1 and Level 2 certificates, which included all six of her subjects in Year 12 being endorsed with excellence, including Level 3 calculus, which she studied a year ahead, placing first equal. The recipient is no stranger to the stage tonight, having received subject awards for excellence in Year 13 Sciences, excellence in Year 13 Biology, the Top Achiever Award for Year 13 Music, the Classics Cup, and a Distinction Award in four of her Year 13 subjects. Last year as a Year 12 student, she also gained a New Zealand scholarship in English. Her academic achievements are outstanding. First in Level 3 Biology, first in Level 3 Classical Studies, first in Level 3 Physics, first equal in Level 3 Chemistry, first equal Level 3 Music, first equal in Level 3 Calculus as a Year 12, New Zealand scholarship in English as a Year 12. It is my absolute pleasure to announce the Academic Ducks for 2024 is Nisha Moorfield.
If we could all have three cheers for the Ducks. Hip hip.
Hooray!
Hip hip.
Hooray!
Hip hip.
Hooray!
Congratulations, Nisha.
Congratulations, ladies. Thank you. Big clap.
With the announcement of our academic ducks, this draws to a close our senior prize giving. Thank you very much to all in attendance for joining us to celebrate this most special occasion. To all prize winners, congratulations once again. There will be an opportunity to take photos with your awards with friends and whānau shortly. However, we do kindly ask that the trophies remain with us and are handed into the stage before you leave. Congratulations again to all prize winners and to those who are graduating today, all the absolute very best. I would now like to invite the Executive Council forward one last time to lead the school song. If we could please be upstanding for the singing of the school song and then remain upstanding for closing karakia, which will be followed by the recessional and the exit of the official party. E tu tātou.
Cause I'm a Ka tau whakatau te kaupapa, ka tau whakatau te wānanga. Kia tau mai te mauri tau, kia tau mai te mauri ora. Haumie, huie, tā kie.
Thank you. Yeah.